Tar sands or oil sands development is one of the dirtiest and most contaminating processes of oil development ever known in history. Alberta, Canada sits atop one of the largest recoverable oil patches. Well, that is, recoverable, if you want to destroy an area the size of Florida or the entire country of England. And that is exactly what's happening now. Developing the tar sands has created not only the biggest industrial development project in the world, the biggest capital investment project in the world, and the biggest energy project in the world, it has also created a literal hell on Earth. Canada's boreal forest, one of the largest and last pristine forests in the world, is being destroyed acre by acre, mile by mile, day after day. And the industry admits that the damage will be irreversible. The oil is stuck in tar sands. It has to be mined out of the ground, squeezed, and boiled. The tar sands uses more water than a city of 2 million people. The tar sands produces an unbelievable 36 million tons of carbon dioxide per day. It causes as much greenhouse gas per day as 1.3 million cars. To produce oil from the tar sands, huge quantities of natural gas have to be used. In 2007 alone, the tar sands used about 1 billion cubic feet of natural gas per day. Gas, in many cases, that was obtained by fracking. Prime Minister Stephen Harper of Canada once called the tar sands development an epic undertaking akin to building the pyramids in Egypt or the Great Wall of China, only bigger. Wastewater is stored in toxic ponds so big that you can see them from outer space. The toxic lakes leak 11 million liters of toxic water a day into groundwater and into nearby rivers used as drinking water sources for the local communities. Oil companies have invested $120 billion in tar sands development. Right now, President Barack Obama is contemplating a proposal for a massive pipeline called the Keystone XL, taking oil from the tar sands in Alberta all across the United States and all across the world. A massive interconnected series of pipelines running all throughout American farmlands, cultural sites, and protected wildlife areas.
Over 50% of the electricity from Site C is needed to go north to the Horn River Basin, north of Fort Nelson, to fuel the shale gas development of the Horn River Basin. Now, there's no transmission line north to the Horn River Basin. So when you hear that Site C, the new estimate is $7.9 billion, that would be, if that plan happens, that will be plus 400 kilometers of new transmission lines. So, you know, $7.9 billion is a lowball estimate. January 2010, an industry magazine, the Oil and Gas Inquirer, had an article about how they want to send Horn River gas to the Alberta tar sands because they extract that tar sands with steam. It's called SAGD, steam-assisted gravity extraction. They need electricity to create that steam, so they're going to take flood a river, create electricity, use it to make highly ecologically damaging natural gas, unconventional gas, send it to the tar sands to take dirty oil, and here's the clincher. That tar sands oil, they're looking at taking it to the west coast to the Enbridge pipeline, supertanker port in killer whale habitat on the west coast.